did a little bit more work on it today. Dragged out some of the Dremel bits. I had to actually order these small drill bits to build my adapter. This is out of PLA. It's 3D printed. It's not finished yet, obviously. The bolts are in the right place, but what I have to do is I have to take a sanding block and go over the back, sort of rub them like that, just to bring them down a little bit. They're a little thick, and then it should be fine. It fits right in here like this. Fit right in there nice, and it lines up with the turntable. So there is a little bit of wiggle room for the, on the bolts. Doesn't look like much now, but it will look pretty factory when I'm finished with it. For the wires, the issue I do have is just spent the last hour trying to get the bolt out of the arm so I can slip the head off, and it is seized, so that's not going anywhere. But what I do have, you can see that, that's the connector there. You see the nice blobs of solder there? Each solder blob is obviously a line. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to sacrifice one of my head shells from Amazon. Probably, well, actually, no, I don't have to do that. I got the wires here. There's green. And the ones I can't pick up. White. You just use these. All the other head shells still have wires, so it's not like I'm stealing it from something else. Okay, so what I'm going to do is just basically cut an end off, strip it, and then solder to the blob that's the right color. I'm not going to be able to show me doing it because I'm going to have a magnifying glass here to do it. It's going to be crazy. But it'll be doable. Where's my light? I'll do this off camera because this is going to take a good chunk, couple of hours to do. But it's doable. Once you get the wire set up, and I'll set an extra finger up down here where I can don't have to hold this, and then I can just work around it. I've done finer work, and then I'll just solder these right to that pad. And once this is finished, I will glue this in, and then plug the wires in. It's done. Look at that, I actually stood there. That's cool. That's basically what the adapter looks like when it fits properly. So yeah, that'll work. Figured I'd give you a quick update. That's what I've been doing for the last couple of hours. And then I had to pull it apart and figure out the pitch. What's going on with that? But, this should save me a couple of bucks on the adapter, if I could find one. Basically, all the adapter is just a chunk of plastic. That's it. And it's got a hole, large hole cut in the top here for the gear for the lock when you turn the handle here. And then it has a thing that locks in the back. But they don't have the thing that locks in the back. And there's a nice gap there where I can work with there. I can have the wires dangling down. So that's a good mod for this turntable if you find one. Then that's the problem here with the thrift store is when you bring it there or when you go to pick it up. It's most people are like, oh, I can't afford $14. Now I need this. So they'll like pull parts off of it. I guarantee you that's where this lifter went and where the needle went. I'm surprised it didn't take the weight. But yeah, I'll see how far I can get on this. Okay, I think I might have found a way to do this without modifying the turntable as it is. Well, I used my extra fingers there with the magnifying glass. And basically wired new leads on the back of the board that's already there. They're all color-coded and set up properly. The beauty part of this, about this, is if I remove the wires, you can still use the pads on the back if you find the adapter for it. This piece that I got in here, it's got to be dremeled off a little bit here. It's a little unsquare, but other than that, it looks pretty good. This is a piece of PLA from a 3D printed box that I made. I believe this is, the thickness is 2.1 or 2.7. if you do decide to make your own, which isn't very hard, 2.3. All right. I would go a little bit thicker than that, only because the bolts and screws that come up on the plate when you make it, say here and here, and they're basically have to be sunk into the plastic for this to be flush and together. It's, as you see, there's no gap there, but on the end there's a little bit of a gap. That's because of the bolts. But what I did is I put adhesive on the bolts and glued them to the adapter. That way you can turn the nuts on the bottom there to remove the cartridge without them spinning freely inside the adapter you made, basically. I've also used shoe goo to glue it on. Down the road, if I decide I get the cartridge and I want that proper part, I could just put a screwdriver in there and turn it and it'll come off. But that is about as good as it's going to get. All I have to do is wait for it to dry and connect the wires properly and we're good to go. That'll take care of that problem. I'll just take once this is dremeled off nice and neat, I'm going to actually put some really thick tape around the head before I dremel it, just in case I hit it. What I'll have to do really after that is just take a nice black marker and just run it along the edge, and it'll blend in with the head. I'm actually kind of happy with that. It hasn't modified anything. You can see the top of the nut there, how close it is to the head shell right there. But it's gonna work. I will not include it in this video, but we're gonna do another video and we're gonna pull the pitch apart. Because it's gonna be a bitch. Cool. Sort of see there where I had to actually dremel out the center. That's because the arm is on a gear, which has got a lock on the end for when the adapter's in there. You can just turn the arm and then it falls down. So you just basically drill a hole in that part there and two other holes below it for the actual cartridge, and it works. Later, guys.